Hey guys, as usual, there is a follow-up to the previous video. This will be a tip follow-up, and it is it's early. It's like 6 a.m., so I'm being a little bit more quiet. So, as someone named, I believe, Nick in the comments of the tip video yesterday, it could have been, I think it was Nick. There's a lot of comments yesterday, and mentioned about how about painting those little clamp areas black so you don't see them as well, so they don't stand out. I mean, when I was getting down like halfway, I could see this nice silver shiny clamp, and you know, he talked me into it. It sounded like a good deal. So I have done a slightly overzealous preparation, and I learned this from my last 1,500 videos I have made on this channel, probably 1,600-700 at this point. Before, I used to do a little half-ass spray paint, and then if I like stopped here, which might have been good in the old days, then when I peeled it off, I'd see a little dusting of paint there. I'd have to wax it off. So always better safe than sorry on this. So the paper, you know, only goes way up to the lights. But in the middle there, it's white, so I wanted to make sure that blanket, just for any dust that comes up, that just doesn't land right there and everything, you know. So yeah, all I'm doing is, where is it? Nothing special, no gloss, no nothing. This is stupid. It's under the car. I am using flame proof. I like the VHT also, as well as the Home Depot one, which I don't think I have over here right now. No, I don't have the Home Depot flat. But the sprayer on the VHT is way better. I suppose I should show you. Can I balance this in my toolbox? Probably not. The sprayer is much, much easier on the fingers than the regular Depot one, which is standard solid peg. This has a nice soft push touch to it, and it's much easier to use. So that's basically the whole idea of the video. Before I move my light, I want to show you how that jack stand adapter is. Remember that? I finally got my first chance to use them, and they're actually really, really, really nice. Now, you may have seen some bad reviews when you went to that Amazon thing. Oh, these crack, these suck. Well, it's all about just how you use them, the smartness of your choices. Now, if you have a razor skinny rail there, sure, and you know, a truck or a heavy car, it could slice into that plastic. But you can see how perfect that adapter is, right into that pinch. And of course, this is the rear of the car also, which is lighter, so it's a lighter test here. But it was so perfect to lift, and you can see right here too, this is where I jacked it with a stand, and then I left this here because it's stuck. I have two of these blue ones, one on each side, and I just leave them there, put the jack back later. You can see, to do the exhaust work, I do have to remove that rear brace too, so it can drop down another 6 inches. Just make sure you get the hanger that is pretty close to that, or you stretch that rubber, maybe break it. There's a hanger almost right across where the camera's pointing right now too, that I had to release. But yeah, that jack thing is pretty good. If you want to look at it deeper and get to see it in the unveiling, go ahead and go to a video 2 or 3 previous, and you'll see a link in there if you want to get those. But so far, I'm really happy. I'm just crouched under here. I can barely talk. I don't see any cracks at all. Of course, it may come with, you know, 10 uses, whatever. But so far, I'm impressed with those. Now I can move the light and just show you a little better what we're going on here. I'm just going to spray this a little bit, mainly back here. I am going to clean it first. It's covered in dirt. Get the alcohol wipes, clean it all up. And I'll just give the edge of this muffler a black spray. Not solid, not super quality. Just the tip. just the tip. Now, I didn't even do that on purpose. Yeah, so I'm just going to spray probably I mean, I don't really need to do the tubes. They're the least viewable thing. But, you know, definitely this side of the tube where, you know, it'd be a little visible, whatever. I'll just spray it, whatever. It's not that complicated. But just showing you did a lot of prep work. I also kind of blocked down here just to not spray my box, the muffler's sitting on, and keep it a little bit clean. Now that I just remembered something else, all the paint dust is going to fall to the ground, and I'll have a big black area here. I'm going to put something down here to cover all the ground too, because I don't want the ground, I mean, it's just garage ground and it's crappy, I don't care, but to keep some of it off, you know, it wouldn't be a bad idea, would it? So, yeah, I'm excited. So I'm going to go ahead and take the alcohol spray, clean it all up. I need to shake this thing up a whole lot and get it nice and creamy for the paint of application. And I don't plan to drive this today. I mean, this stuff dries in about 5 minutes, but we're going out in the afternoon in the rain. I'll probably just take her beautiful Forester XTI. Yeah, that's right, you haters. Forester XTI black spoiler. I was just thinking about how much I loved it as I drove it to get coffee today with those yellow fogs from JDM A-Star. JDM A-Star has brand new 4S generation out now. I'm trying to obtain a test kit of that so I can swap out her old 4S for the new 4S. And they still have all the colors too. And I won't show you the yellow fogs again. They're so beautiful. I've showed you them a lot of times. But yeah, the yellow fogs are totally awesome. Oh, that's just a bit of rubber. I thought that might have been a crack. I got nervous. And remember that, not that this is a Forester video, but I do have the brand new Michelin All Seasons on this Forester, which are sick. I wish I could afford them on this, but I can't. Remember, any quick little plug, any Amazon link you click in my videos gives me 25 cents, maybe 50 cents, whatever. If you do need to get something on Amazon, maybe you can click through one of my links and then buy anything at all. And it will help the channel, help me grow, and help more mods come to this place. Got to get tires, got to get a unibrace, got to get a rear sway bar. And I'm probably forgetting one thing that's left on my list. Probably a fluid dampener, harmonic balancer pulley. But yeah, I think I'm convinced I can do the install. Been talking to Paul at DAP Auto a little bit, one of the biggest channel sponsors here. And I think I can really handle it. I do have a... Where is my big, big bar? I got this for the WRX fluid dampener pulley, remember? Company 23 holder. I mean, it's not factory, but it'll work great. Of course, the whole concern with the VW harmonic balancer is that the inner plate, after you move the pulley, well, the pulley itself, too, is related to the timing with all those notches. And if you put it on wrong, you mess up the timing. I've seen one or two horror stories with that and people screwed it up. But most likely, I mean, I've been doing this a lot of years. I could probably be one of the successful ones, but there's always a risk and I'm nervous about it. All right, I kind of went off on a tangent there. I'm going to shut this down. I'm going to start shaking up the paint and get to it.
It looked a little dark. I thought, man, is this gloss? But it'll turn very ungloss as soon as it dries, like all those flat paints. You'll think it's glossy, and then it'll turn like flat. That's all I'm doing here. Just a front tip. Just the tip. That's it. Let it dry. Look. Oh, man, that looks good. Can you guys? I got a crappy light bulb here, but hey, better than nothing. And hey, it looks so good. I'm gonna, of course, finish this. I got everything mostly blocked off. Oh, that does look good. Whoa. Try and get in the bottom. It's a little tricky back here. Oh, man. Oh, left-handed press. I hate those. I can't get a very confident push on the spray with my left finger because I'm right-handed. There we go. Beautiful. Oh my god, this is better than I thought. Thanks, Nick. Nick, dude. I pulled out the Forester, maybe you can see.
And I am painting the threads on the clamp, whatever. I can bust through them if I need to. I know, it's not supposed to paint the threads. I wasn't gonna tape them off. Beautiful, wow. You can see it's all, well, some of the light coats, they're already getting, they're drying flat and they're not glossy anymore. I need to get up here a little bit. Oh, that's already flat. You'll see it's completely flat very shortly. I especially want to get the rim of the muffler here, which could be visible. Oh, that's beautiful. This was an awesome idea from someone else. Just like I did a lot of this on my WRX, you know. Remember, just sound deadening, the muffler, heat shields, etc. Just real, like, real small stuff, but all adds up to the most beautiful build in the world. You know how it works. Take care of those small details, and you'll have the car that they go, man, that's a nice detail. I didn't think of that. And you go, well, now you can. Now you can do it. But, I mean, I don't need to get underneath, really. And it's probably going to make it drip. But again, I don't care. This is under the car. All right. Freaking awesome. Let me get you a... Let me see. How can I do this? Turn it around. Get you a quick bird's eye view before I shut the camera off. I will now bring the camera, the light lower, and really let you see what it looks like. You can see it's drying there. Well, maybe, so yeah, see that dry spot? So it is not gonna be glossy, even though glossy looks good, by the way. But yeah, I don't need to have glossy mufflers. That's better, look at that. And of course, my tips are very protected with double tape, sealed all of it, don't wanna spray my carbon, my fake carbon. Beautiful. All right, get this tripod in place. So yeah, I am gonna do two or three coats. I don't want the first rock to, you know, chip it off, whatever. But yeah, that's about it. That's the video. Blacking out the whole rear station. I think it looks beautiful, really beautiful. Can't wait to see it. It'll look even better. One last thought. Let me turn this so it's tight again. Bring it up to where it should be. I'm holding my tripod. A crappy tripod, a $20 Amazon Basics tripod that already, one of the legs already broke off it. Damn, what was I just saying? Yeah, I get a little runaway of the mind. Tips. A quick thought. So yesterday after the tip install, what was I thinking? Super excited the whole time. Little bit sad about cutting my raw tips, of course. That can't be helped. And so right when I was done, I was kind of thinking, they're a little too big right at that moment. And I just went off and, you know, thought I just went off and had a couple, 2-3 hours free in my life. Then I came back, and at that time I was thinking I could also drill out those rivets, pull off the carbon, and I have perfectly metal tips just like before, except bigger, a good situation. But I came back 3 hours later, and as soon as I looked at it, I liked it. It was weird, like I changed a little bit. You know, right when you did it, the sting was kind of hard for cutting up a nice cat-back. But as soon as I saw them again, after I had stepped away for a while, I liked them more. And I started really liking them. And I said, okay, these do look good. They're a good size. They look tough. They look interesting. And I don't always want to be the invisible car, you know. I do go stealthy most of the time. I spit. But, they really grew on me, and that's why I'm going this extra step with a spray paint, full circle here, to finish the job real nice, because I didn't want to leave it half-assed if I'm going to keep them. I did decide they're going to be on a little while, just probably a longer than I think, because I have there's no way I can put other tips on them, except tips of the same inlet size, since that's cut now. But yeah, at first I wasn't so sure. Afterwards, I really started warming up to them, and that's where we're at on that. Show you before I hang up right now and end this video, show you how the flat is drying. See that? So it's perfect, really. It's stealthy, it's not flashy, not big bright black shiny. It's just stealthy, blacks it out. That's the name of the game. I'll see you guys later. Thanks for the support. Alright guys, I got 3 coats and I wanted to just show you a final result before I button all this up. Very sweet. 3 nice coats, you know,
that'll go away when it dries, whatever. It's all hidden anyway, but that's going to be really sweet. Look at the sides there. Blacked out for the most part. Sweet. What about that right there? Yeah, it's just reflections. Pretty dark, pretty nice. And this side here, very sweet. I think it looks really, really awesome having that blacked out muffler down there. Of course, I'm going to tuck it up about a foot now, and it'll be nice and stealthy and hidden anyway. But I think this was a nice little mod to really bring the car up a little bit. Suppose since you're right here, you probably want to see it bolted up. That's almost bolted up, but not fully. And you can see right here, you don't even notice the muffler anymore. Really sweet. Sort of like that. Yeah, final. I'm going to bring it up another half inch, and we're all good to go. Sweet.